Security was tight at the Monarch Gala. You took quite a risk walking into the lion's den.
If we were gonna kidnap Dr. Amaral, then we needed to do it from the inside.
Beth Wilder, you were quick to trust her.
We had common interests.
Is that all you had?
It's all we needed.
Thanks for showing up.
Here, I thought this was gonna be a rescue. Right, there's a story here.
You know a guy called Hatch?
Serene's right-hand man.
He was here. He gave me this big speech about how he wants to take down Paul.
I hope you said no.
I didn't trust him for a second. He set me loose anyways, told me to wait for an opening.
I just gave you one.
Appreciate it. What's it look like out there?
I think you're secure. Everyone's concentrating on the party. So far, your crazy plan's working.
And Dr. Amaral?
I don't have a fix on her. She's either at the party or at her office at the R&D facility here on the island. I'll scout out the party.
So you're gonna sip champagne while I break into a high-security installation? It's like you got this all figured out.
I'll save you a cocktail, weenie.
Oh, well, in that case...
My cover isn't gonna survive the night, but it'll last a little longer, so you can't walk out the front door with me. This is the quickest way to the R&D facility. I disabled the security at the back door, but there'll be guards. Contact me when you're clear. And Jack, you know what's at stake here. This can't be about revenge.
I'm not here for Paul. That will hurt in the morning.
My powers were growing. I was learning to control them better. That felt good.
There must be some way to open the door. Who the hell designs these doors? Okay, I'm gonna have to move faster to get through. Very sci-fi and very monarch. Something tells me it wasn't commissioned by them, though. Hey, Beth, I'm clear. What's next?
You'll see a radar tower up ahead soon. Let me know when you get inside.
All right. Hey, Beth, I'm clear. What's next?
We'll see a radar tower up ahead soon. Let me know when you get inside.
All right. Warn me about that one, Beth. Okay, how am I getting to that radar tower? Up you go. Let's try this again. That's it.
Hey, it was just our people there. We can spin it however we want. Call it an accident. Or pin it on Joyce.
Yeah, he might as well take the blame for the mess he made.
Weapons free!
Time felt broken here. Monarch built over World War II fortifications. Made me wonder why they chose that island.
The existing tunnel system led back to the mainland. Perfect for construction of a highly secretive R&D facility.
The whole canon felt unstuck in time. Monarch had dismantled the old cannon.
It's locked.
The timeline of the old cannon felt loose. I could shift it around.
Smart place to aim the cannon, guys.
Monarch projections say these stutters are getting more frequent. If one hits while we're grabbing Dr. Amaral...
You'll be frozen. Yeah, I know. It's a risk.
Monarch specialist troopers have the stutterproof gear. I bet Dr. Amaral would have that in her office, too.
I'll keep an eye out. See if I can grab it for you.
I can't believe that Joyce guy just gave himself up. That's crazy. Yeah, well, he's locked up tight now. I hope they put two in the back of his head. Is it true he's got some kind of powers? I mean, without the gear. Yeah, it's true. That freaks me out. Dangerous motherfucker. I heard Hatch made him a personal visit. Yeah. I think he's like an animal to sit down with someone like Joyce.
Position. Come back.
Thanks, Beth. It's over. I need to get to the radar tower. Okay, next stop, the radar tower. Beth, I'm at the radar tower. Where's the lab?
Below your feet. It's all top secret. The elevator inside will take you down.
Oh, seriously? What is this, a Bond villain lair?
You have no idea.
This is Teresa.
Just don't fall into the shark tank.
Happy to spend this fine evening with you. We're gonna have a good time.
Fuck.
Tonight marks a momentous occasion. For years, we have been building towards this day.
Years of planning, developing, training. For me personally, this marks the end of a 17-year journey, and today we emerge from the shadows. We do so accepting great responsibility. I present to you the CFR.
Speech is streaming. Let's give Monarch the audience
Cronon
they deserve.
Field Regulator. This device has been at the heart of our Cronon research since 2010, but I am here to assure you that it is so much more than just that. This device will be our salvation, and as promised, it is ready. To some of you, this means nothing. To others, everything. Rest assured, you will all know when the time is right. We are entering a volatile age. Great danger is coming our way. It cannot be prevented, but we can be protected. And so tonight is a celebration. A celebration in the face of darkness. We celebrate, but for some of you, this means nothing. For others, everything. Rest assured, you will all know when the time is right. We are entering a volatile age. Great danger is coming our way. It cannot be prevented, but we can be protected. And so tonight is a celebration in face of darkness. Tonight we celebrate because I promise to you that we are prepared. We are prepared for what comes next. We are prepared to do what is necessary. We are prepared to survive. Thank you.
Beth, I'm about to take the elevator. I see Paul's still fond of his own voice.
Yeah, he's talking about his survival plan. Crowd's eating it up.
Dr. Amaral's office. Looks like that's one level up. Frequent.
The device drained my powers.
We refer to it as a chronon dampener.
Serene ordered Hatch to kill me because he didn't want to put his plan at risk. Seeing the scale of that facility, I started realizing just how deep that plan went. It made me wonder. Time was ending. What was it all for? Bad, Jack.
Looks like I need to find another way inside.
Thank you.
device drain my powers?
We refer to it as a Cronon dampener.
Serene ordered Hatch to kill me because he didn't want to put his plan at risk. Seeing the scale of that facility, I started realizing just how deep that plan went. Made me wonder. Time was ending. What was it all for? The device drained my powers.
We refer to it as a Cronon dampener.
Serene ordered Hatch to kill me because he didn't want to put his plan at risk. But seeing the scale of that facility, I started realizing just how deep that plan went. Made me wonder. Time was ending. What was it all for?
How am I getting hit? That's the last of them.
The chart showed that all of Monarch's major technological advancements started in 2010. Around the same time that something else happened.
Ground Zero.
What the fuck is that thing?
The device drained my powers.
We refer to it as a chronon dampener.
The chart showed that all of Monarch's major technological advancements started in 2010. Around the same time that something else happened.
Ground Zero.
The device drained my powers.
We refer to it as a chronon dampener.
Serene ordered Hatch to kill me because he didn't want to put his plan at risk. But seeing the scale of that facility, I started realizing just how deep that plan went. It made me wonder. Time was ending. What was it all for? These things were designed by walking tanks.
They weren't for you. Don't flatter yourself.
Which way is Amron's office? Might be able to get out from here. again. I'm guessing this isn't the usual employee route.
I knew that Monarch had technology to let their soldiers move in stutters, but this was bigger than that. Somehow, time flowed normally in that area. Suddenly, Monarch's lack of concern about time stopping made a hell of a lot more sense.
Dr. Amaral's office must be close. No alarms. Looks like nobody here knows about the mess I made on the way in. Nice job, Beth. That's Emma's office.
Thank you.
That there looks like what Beth wanted. Oh, shit. Emerald's at the party. The stutter won't last. I better find a way out of here and get to the party.
Amaral had tried to warn Paul. The end of time was approaching quickly. Less than 24 hours away.
Mr. Serene believed it would take years to run its course. Admittedly, he was wrong.
Quite expensive piece of tech you stole.
Bill me. I knew Beth's cover wouldn't last long. Had to get it to her at the party before it was too late. The Monarch combat gear was unwieldy. What I'd taken from Dr. Amaral's office was much lighter. Almost like a civilian model.
Thank you.
garage. Sounds like the way out of this place. There we go. All I had to do was make it through the garage. Seems simple enough.
What are they gonna do to that Burke guy?
After what he pulled, you gotta figure he's dead, right?
Go check it out.
What the fuck? Alert!
Oh, shit.
All personnel, Jack Joyce has escaped custody and is now present at the R&D facility garage. Repeat, Jack Joyce has escaped custody. He is to be neutralized at all costs.
Keep an eye on him!
Thank you.
is not gonna make my life any easier. There's gotta be a way out of here.
Adventures in Flesh by L. Hakola. Chapter 11.
Is somebody playing an audiobook over the radio?
Finally,
whoever that is, shut it off now.
His dungeon.
I think I'll just leave that right there.
Somebody find out where that's coming from. This is supposed to be a secure channel.
Damn. The alarm must have locked everything down. Maybe I can turn it off. Oh, shit. Okay. That's what I'm talking about. Beth, I got that device for you, but Dr. Amaral's at the party.
Yeah, I just spotted her. Wanna be my date?
Yeah, save me that cocktail weenie. I'll make my way there.
Serene's finished his speech and he knows you're loose. He's headed your way. Remember what we said. I'll keep him occupied, but switch to the Monarch frequency to make sure you stay out of his crosshairs.
Okay, I'll see you at the party.
Shotgun, moving in!
I got that device for you, but Dr. Amaral's at the party.
Yeah, I just spotted her. Wanna be my date?
Yeah, save me that cocktail weenie. I'll make my way there.
Serene's finished his speech and he knows you're loose. He's headed your way. Remember what we said. I'll keep him occupied, but switch to the Monarch frequency to make sure you stay out of his crosshairs.
Okay, I'll see you at the party. I got that device for you, but Dr. Amaral's at the party.
Yeah, I just spotted her. Wanna be my date?
Yeah, save me that cocktail weenie. I'll make my way there.
Serene's finished his speech and he knows you're loose. He's headed your way. Remember what we said. I'll keep him occupied. I'll switch to the Monarch frequency to make sure you stay out of his crosshairs.
Okay. I'll see you at the party. Oh.
Copy. All units be advised, we have a situation. Be on standby for relocation to target center. That's the last of them.
Good evening, Riverport. It's Teresa here again. I've got a fresh bagel and a big cup of coffee and a perfectly lovely audience. And everything's all right in my world.
Joyce, ASAP. Monarch Actual is moving in to intercept.
This is Home Guard 5. Just spotted him entering the tunnel system outside the party grounds.
Beth?
I'm on my way.
He took out my entire squad. Requesting immediate backup in here.
Attention all units. Reroute to the tunnels immediate.
Negative. Seal off all exit points, but I go in alone. He's mine.
Nice work. I could see the mansion where the gala was. I had to find a way to get there. I could see the energy field of another Monarch Chronon dampener. It would drain my powers. I'd have to find a way to shut it off.
All right. Thank you.
towers won't work within that sphere. I better be careful. My powers won't work within that sphere. I better be careful. Security's tight.
Somebody get Slade back here!
Yeah.
Thank you.
Crystal.
You were headed for the party. What was your plan?
I needed to get to Dr. Amaral before the stutter ended and Monarch found out I was coming.
This is the only tunnel entrance Joyce could have entered through.
Secure the exit. I'm going in alone.
Sir, are you sure you don't want support?
We've seen what Jack can do. I'm the only one who can stop him. If he gets to the mainland, we lose him for good. Secure the exit.
Should be here somewhere. Need to get to her before the stutter ends.
Mr. Serene's speech had been a success.
The world was falling apart, but the wine and cheese crowd was enjoying their little goddamn soiree. Got here.
no idea I've been shooting up half a Paul's little amusement park.
Yeah, well, Monarch does. I don't think my cover's gonna last.
Yeah, well, I don't think it would do much good for the next part anyway.
Okay, Dr. Amaral's somewhere inside the mansion. Let's go grab her. Bit of luck, we can be gone before anybody notices.
Okay, lead the way. Hey, there we go.
We need to get to Dr. Amaral's office. The stutter can collapse any second.
What's our plan once we grab her?
There's a boat dock right outside the mansion.
Okay, we can make that work. Place at the wrong time, literally.
Jack, Dr. Amaral's in there. We need to get her out before time kicks back. Jack, get her moving before time kicks back in and that drone turns us into paste.
Let's get to it, Doctor.
Wait, what? Oh no, that's gonna be good. It's really happening. You're Jack Joyce. You're here to kill me.
No, but you're coming with us. We need your expertise.
No.
I'm not asking.
Where's the damn boat?
It's right there.
Okay, go! Get her on the boat, I'll keep you
going. Come on, Doctor!
Oh, hurry up!
You'll never get away with this.
Shit.
Get in!
Joyce, somehow we got right past us. Go, let him escape. Somebody call the Supreme.
Jack, they're closing the gate. We'll be sitting ducks here unless you get it open for us.
I'll take care of it. You get going the second you can, okay?
Moving in on target!
Gotta move.
Changing mag! Suppressing!
Eyes on the target! Copy that. All units, there are some hostiles that you can get underway. All units on high alert.
Jack, they're closing the gate. We'll be sitting ducks here unless you get it open for us.
Joyce!
I'll take care of it.
I got a visual.
No!
Jack, they're closing the gate. We should have got here unless you get it open for us.
I'll take care of it. You get going the second you can, okay? Need to open that gate.
That gate's still closed. What's up?
Yeah, I'm still working on it. Hang tight. Clear. Go.
I can swing by
go.
And...
No. Just go. We went to all this trouble to grab her. Beth, I'm counting on you to keep her alive. Make my own way out.
My plan was simple. There was a bridge to the mainland. I'd fight my way through anything Monarch would throw at me and then steal a car, drive it back to the swimming pool.
Just remember, we need your ass alive for the next part.
We'll see how it shakes out.
Thank you. weapons free! Move up to his flank! Circle around!
With Beth and Dr. Amaral clear, it was time for me to get gone. For that, I needed wheels.
Okay, time to get a ride out of here.
Valet parking. Beloved by car thieves everywhere.
This thing growing inside me. I've been fighting it for 6 hard years. Dr. Amaral was developing a cure for the Cronon syndrome. She was the only one who could administer the treatments that kept my sickness at bay.
Paul?
And Jack had taken her away from me.
Morton, how is it possible they managed to take her?
Paul, this is your illness talking. I'm on your side. Easy, you're...
They took her. Without Sophia, there's no chance of a cure.
We did all we could. But there are forces within Monarch working against you, and I believe Burke was just the tip of the iceberg. It wasn't just Joyce that did this.
Sir? We've recovered Dr. Amaral's laptop. We have it set up over there if you want to take a look.
I'll be right there. I want to go over Sophia's figures. If she's right, the fracture is escalating a lot faster than we anticipated.
You know the future. Dr. Emerald doesn't. Is the lifeboat even in a viable state for activation? She's trying to convince you the schedule's wrong. Why? To get you to rush this? To make a mistake? The people opposing you. She could be one of them.
She isn't.
Are you willing to bet the entire plan on that? I implore you, hold off on activation, Paul. Let me clean house before this gets completely out of hand.
I should have been here. Somebody made a false report. Sent me to the tunnels to divert my attention.
Like I said, people working against you.
Who was that on the radio?
We're still working on that. Do you want to see this laptop or not? At least your speech went over well.
Any assurance we gave them was taken away the second Jack opened fire.
How do you want to proceed?
Somebody was working against me. Somebody close. Martin Hatch. Sophia Amaral. I could only trust one of them.
All right, Amaral. Let's go fix the time machine.
I'll try.
Evidence was mounting against Sophia. I couldn't simply ignore it, despite everything we had been through.
But she knew you'd never make it without those troopers. And then she took them away.
If she'd turned against me with what she knew, the damage could be immeasurable. Martin had been my closest advisor for years. I began to wonder if that had been a mistake.
Sophia's loyal. She's always been loyal.
I don't think we can trust her. The way she looked at the countermeasure like she's seen it before. She knows what it does.
Sophia's research had saved my life. Loyalty doesn't run any deeper. You're right. We need to stick to the original plan. Whether Sophia's data is good or not, we can't deviate from that. Clearly, we have been compromised. Put a team together. Find out who she's been working with.
Actually, I've already got something on that front. They just pulled this from the security feed.
My God, it's her.
Who?
Her, Martin. She's one of our employees. How the hell?
We got too big for you to screen everybody personally. We didn't have an ID on her. Until now. Beth Wilder. She's one of our operatives. We've already got a kill team after, but...
We won't be able to kill her. Not yet. How can she be working with Jack? How does she even know him?
I told you, Paul, we can't trust our own people. Who knows how deep this goes?
Find out. Beth Wilder.
It was the first time I'd heard her name. But she had been there in the past. When it all started. She'd been here the whole time, working against me from the inside. And she wasn't the only one.
The treatments. They're losing their effectiveness.
Sophia, you shouldn't worry so much. Back up slowly.
I need to get in that lab. There's something in there that I need.
The lifeboat protocol.
Paul's a very dangerous man, and things will only get worse if he continues unchecked.
What is it that you're so threatened by, Martin?
Do I look threatened to you?
This is Dr. Amaral's report. The stutters, they're increasing in frequency.
What is that?
A Kronon disrupted life form. Extremely hostile. It's Dr. Kim.
Let's go! Let's go! Kronon, don't! Put one of those on!
The hatch.
And what did Burke want with it?
Well, I don't know. I don't even know what the lifeboat protocol is.
It's a sanctuary designed to shelter a list of Monarch's essential personnel to weather the storm until they can develop a solution.
Essential personnel. So that means that I'd be on that list, right?
Not under Paul Serene's lead, you wouldn't. He's failed to see the value in his own people. Too consumed with grand ideals and delusions. You know what I find to be the most terrifying notion on this planet? The idea of God. Simply the idea. A being with that much power. The ability to take and give so freely. That kind of control. It should be feared, not worshipped. Yet people believe in it. Just as people believe in Paul Serene. See, what's so scary about God? Isn't his control, but rather, if he ever lost it, Paul Serene's become unhinged, Charlie. He's triggered a catastrophe. He has the chance to fix it, but he's choosing not to. He's choosing to let things end.
The end of time.
And this is where we come in. We risk too much leaving the keys to the kingdom in one man's hands. We need insurance. There's something called the CFR. It's a crucial key to our survival and must remain safe. But as long as Paul is the only one with access to it, it isn't. With access to the CFR, I would take over. Get Monarch back on track, and once I do, restructuring would be in order, Charlie. Restructuring that would see you as my right hand.
I'd be on the list.
Absolutely.
Then I need to go back to Monarch. And that sort of privilege escalation, it can only be done from the inside. That's good.
I put the island on lockdown, but the pump house on the west side has an old supply tunnel that runs beneath the bay. No one knows about it. You'll go unseen. Time is of the essence, Charlie. Better get to it. Commander Davis.
Yes, sir.
Head to the perimeter lab. We're moving forward.
The frequency of the stutters is still unpredictable, but they're persistent. Erratic, but persistent.
I need certainty. If I initiate the protocol, there's no going back.
Mr. Serene, something like this. There is no certainty. We've never dealt with it before.
How long?
We've been running Dr. Amaral's simulations. It's hard to say without her to confirm, but...
Just give me a time.
The Joyce Field could collapse within 8 hours. Mr. Serene, if you're going to proceed, now would be the time to decide.
Charlie. Fiona.
Hey, bud. Where you going?
You're right. Time's ending, just like you said. And the lifeboat protocol, it's a place. They built it to protect people from the fracture. And the only problem is there's a list, and anyone who's not on it is pretty much fucked. But if we make it back to the mainland, I can get us on the list. All of
this entire island is on lockdown. How are we gonna do that, Charlie?
There's a tunnel.
Hey, all right, if you are lying to me this time, I swear to God.
No, get off! Tired of shit. I don't know why you're doing this, but I don't have to put your name on shit, motherfucker.
What'd you do to him?
He's fine. I'm gonna tell you why you're gonna put me on that list. I got a pregnant wife at home, and she's the only thing that I am thinking about right now. So if you get in the way of me protecting her, I swear to fucking God, next time, you will not catch your breath. Lead the way.
Dr. Emerald.
Squirmed in my restraints. So, he said, here we are.
5 minutes out, Mr. Hatch.
What is that?
Not sure. Just playing when we came in.
Into the darkest dungeon, located in the soft, damp underbelly.
Come to free you, my friend. This imprisonment is unsettling. It's time for you to rejoin the others, to return to the infinite.
Your wife?
3 months.
Congratulations.
You okay?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. I'm good. We need to get...
Get on the fucking ground!
Hey!
Ground.
No, we're with Monarch!
What don't you understand?
No,
get on the ground!
Hey, no. Hey, I'm the one that called it in. I'm Hatch's guy.
Wincott?
Yeah.
Where's she?
She's... Chronon scientist. She's important. We have to get her back to Monarch right away. Please.
Get the fuck out of here.
Now! Yeah.
Gibson, I got Burke.
Fiona! Fiona, you gotta listen. Hey!
Ah! Shit, you killed him!
Fuck! Hey! I didn't know that they were gonna kill him. What was I supposed to do? Huh? You led me on and then you kidnapped me.
This isn't about you, Charlie!
Are you stealing this car?
Just get the fuck out of here.
No, you're gonna need me.
I got what I needed out of you.
Yeah, I'm getting used to it.
Why don't you open your eyes? The world is about to end. I'm trying to do something.
Yeah, you're a real hero.
Fuck you.
Mars, huh? I'll see you there.
Burke.
You fuck.
You know, I'm really gonna enjoy killing your wife.
Commander Davis.
Davis and his team. They're all good men. Monarch's finest.
Paul, what about my treatments?
I'm afraid so.
You know what this means.
You don't know for sure.
I'm a dead man! Jack. He wants me to become him. He wants me to suffer. Until the end.
Joyce and Wilder. But what was troubling me is who got them into Kim's lab. She paid a visit while she was thought to be missing. She knew where your treatments were kept. She knew the complexities of your illness. And she knew you'd never make it without those treatments.
She created them.
And then she took them away.
I need her found now.
And what would you like done with her?
I'll decide that when she's brought to me.
Liam?
Hey, pal. I'm glad you could make it. I was just telling your girl here how concerned about you we've been.
Emily. We need to go.
Go? What's the rush?
Emily. Let's go.
Shut up!
Emily, give me the keys. Give me the keys,
get
Emily.
Away from me,
Emily, listen.
No.
Listen, please. Please, please. This is not who I am. This is not. I'm telling you, I never felt good doing this. I never felt good doing this. But it's the only thing I knew how to do. And when I got back, I couldn't find anything. I couldn't find anything to do. And Monarch, they found that useful, and they put me to work. I swear to God, I couldn't stand being alone. So every Tuesdays and Wednesdays, I would walk down the street because it was the only two nights at the bartender. She wasn't at school. And I told myself every night to ask you about it. It took me a fucking year. Emily, if Monarch, if they gave me structure, you gave me purpose. I did this to protect you. I did this to protect us, our family. I did this to protect our family. And Emily, you have to listen to me. Something terrible is coming, and I will explain to you on the way, but we have to move. We have to move right now. If you will just let me, if you will just let me protect you one last time.
Yeah, it's Pierce. I'm at the perimeter lab. Sir, I have some information about Martin Hatch.
I want him apprehended. Immediately.